In this video, we're going to work on counting sig figs. As you come across numbers in your problems, those numbers stand for measurements, and you're going to need to know how to count how many sig figs there are in that number. There are several rules. We're going to go through them one at a time. The first one is easy. Any number that has non-zero digits, such as 225, all of those digits are counted as sig figs. There are 3 sig figs in the number 225. Even if there's a decimal, for example 2.25, that number has 3 sig figs. There they are. SF stands for significant figures, or significant digits means the same thing. There are 3 sig figs there. So all non-zero digits are counted as significant figures. If you have zeros, it gets a little trickier. The first type of zero we'll take care of is zeros between other non-zero digits. For example, if you have the number 2025, 2025, the 2 and the 5 are absolutely significant based on the first rule. The zero is also counted as significant because it is between non-zero digits. There are 4 sig figs in this number. Even if you have a decimal, this rule still stands. If I have 2.025, there are 4 sig figs in this value. If I have the number 20.05, both of those zeros are counted as significant figures. There are 4 significant figures in that number. If you have zeros at the beginning of a value, those are not counted as significant. As we start looking at these are going to be numbers that begin with decimal places. It is a very good habit to get into to start writing a zero right before a number that begins with a decimal place. So for example, if I have the number 0.25, I really should write it as 0.25. And that zero is not counted as a significant figure. It is simply setting off the decimal place. There are 2 sig figs in 0.25. If I have some other zeros leading into my decimal number, for example 0.00025, again I should write that first zero to set off the decimal place, but none of these zeros are significant. They are placeholders. There are 2 sig figs in this last number. Now I have to write the zeros because they are placeholders, but they're not counted as significant figures. All right, to begin the next section, let's go ahead and clear this off. What we're going to talk about next is counting sig figs when you have zeros after the number. This is a little bit trickier. If you have a zero after a number, in the case that there is a decimal place written, for example, let's look at our 0.025. If I write a zero after the 2 and the 5, that zero is counted as significant. The first 2 zeros are not, because of the last rule, but the 2, the 5, and the last zero are counted as significant, and there are 3 significant figures in this number. The reason why the last zero is significant is because I could actually just not write it, and it would still be numerically the same value, but I write it because it gives me some information about the measurement. It is counted as a significant figure. So no matter how many zeros there are at the end of this number, I have written them because they are part of the measurement. If I have 25.000, this decimal place indicates that these following zeros are significant. The 2 and the 5, of course, are significant. The last 3 zeros are as well. There are 5 significant figures in this last number. I could leave these zeros off. Numerically, I would have exactly the same value, but I have written them because they are part of the measurement. So zeros at the end, when I do have a decimal place showing up, are counted as significant. If instead I write the number 250, now in this case, this last zero has to be written. I can't leave it off and still have the same value. If I left it off, I'd have 25. But because I have not put a decimal at the end of this, I don't count it as significant. It's a placeholder. The 2 and the 5 are significant. The last zero has to be written to hold the place, but there are only 2 sig figs in this number. the number 25000, 25,000. Again, the 2 and the 5 are significant, but I don't count these last 3 zeros. I have to write them, but I don't count them because they're placeholders. They're not part of the measurement. There are 2 sig figs here. Now, if instead I wrote 250 and put a decimal place, this is the notation to indicate that all 3 of these are significant figures. I have 3 significant figures here. If I wrote 250.0, again, we saw an example of this a minute ago, now I have 4 sig figs. All right. If I have the number 0.0025000, these zeros at the end are significant because there's a decimal place that shows up. There are 5 sig figs in this last number. But zeros at the end without a decimal place, 20,500. The 2, the 0, and the 5 here at the beginning are. These zeros are placeholders. There are only 3 sig figs here.